Hi guys, welcome back to Edge Automation. So welcome to next session in Maven series, and in this session we are going to see how to use a Maven project as a dependency in another Maven project. Okay, so let's say you have two Maven project, project 1 and project 2. So you are going to reuse the project 1. Okay, you are going to create a dependency for project 1 and that we will use in project 2. Okay, so what I am going to show you is, let's say we have these two projects, okay, project 1 and project 2. Now project 1 has all the classes, okay, and functions available and some of the utilities. Okay, so all these classes, methods and utilities are working here in project 1. So I want to use all these classes and methods available in the classes and all these utilities in another Maven project, okay, in this project 2. Okay, so that I can reuse all these codes available, they are already working. Okay, so I don't have to redefine redeclare all the classes and utilities here. Okay, I can directly reuse them. Okay, so how can we do that? In previous lecture we have created the jar file, okay, and we have seen that how to reuse the all these classes and methods in project 2. Okay, but now in this session we are going to create or use the Maven project as a dependency. Okay, so in the same way, like you add Selenium test ng dependency in pom.xml, we will add a Maven project 1 dependency in pom.xml of project 2. Okay, so we will go stepwise. Okay, so if you follow these steps you will not face any issue, just follow the step by step process. Okay, so first step is you need to add jar plugin. Okay, you need to create the jars of your Maven project 1. Okay, so for that you need to add this much information in your pom.xml of the project 1. Okay, so currently our project 1 pom.xml, I have added some common dependencies. Okay, the Selenium test ng and this WebDriver manager. Okay, so here we will add our jar plugin. Okay, okay, under build tag save it, and next step is you can add whatever dependencies are required. Okay, so as of now we have just added three dependencies, Selenium, test ng and WebDriver manager. Okay, so when we add the project 1 dependency in project 2, you will not require to add a single dependency there. These dependencies are already as a part of project 1, and if you add that dependency in project 2, okay, in pom.xml of project 2, you don't have to add all the dependencies. Okay, you don't have to add this, just add a dependency for project 1. Okay, and that will work fine. Okay, so let us create jar file for project 1 first. Okay, so before creating the jar, it is good practice to, you know, run your test cases first. Okay, check if test cases are running or fine or not. Okay, if they are running fine, then only you can create the jar file. Okay, so for running your test case, let me add the SurePy plugin somewhere here. Yes, here it is. Okay, let me add it in pom.xml of project 1. Okay, so we have added SurePy plugin, jar plugin and couple of dependencies in project 1. So let us run this first, and you can, what command you can use to create the jar file is here. The next step is, once you added the dependency, third step is create the jar file. Okay, so if you use this Maven install command, that will run your test case, that will first compile the test case, then run your test case, and then it will create the jar file. Okay, and those jar files will be installed in your M2 repository. Okay, so let me show you. In the jar plugin we have added this final name as project jars and project. Okay, so that means under the target folder, Okay, once jars are created, under target folder, project jars folder will be there, and under that we will get two files. One is project jar and another is project test jar. Okay, so project jar will contains all the classes from this com.pages, all the classes from this com.utilities. Okay, and project test jar will contains only classes from this test cases from src test java. Okay, so let us run this and see. So to run this, right click on this, run as maven install. Okay, build is success. That means our jar are ready and that are present in target folder, project jars. Okay, so here also you can see, go to target, we'll just have to refresh this in project jars here. Okay, you can see here two jars are available. Okay, so you are under the Eclipse, you can see that in your local machine as well. That just let me show you that. Okay, so you need to go to the project location. Okay, so for that, right click on your project, go to properties, and this is the location where project is available. So just click on that arrow. Under this project we will have target folder, and under the project jars we will have two jars. Okay, to check the contents of this jar you can use the JDD compiler application. Okay, that you can download from the Google JDD compiler. So let me open it. Okay, so just select these two jars here. Okay, so that will show you the contents of jar. Okay, so project jar contains two package pages and all the classes available will be there. Okay, 9 classes are there, and class files for the utilities. Okay, so all these are the class file, dot class files. Okay, and same jars will be available in your M2 repository as well. Okay, so under target folder, project jars. Okay, so this will contain project jar and project test jar. Okay, so project jar will contains classes from, okay, classes from src main java. Okay, and this project test jar will contains classes from src test java. Okay, so if you check contents of project tests, you can see here the test cases, all the classes, class file from the test case package. Okay, so currently we have added only two classes here. Okay, so if you go to M2 repository where your project is there, there also you will find two jar files. Okay, so one, there is a format by which these files will be stored. So that will be stored in the format artifact ID. Artifact ID, then there will be version number, whatever you are provided. Okay, this is the for project jar. Okay, this is for main classes jar file. Okay, and test classes jar file. Okay, that will be having same format, only at the last there will be tests. Okay, so this will be present in M2 repository. Okay, dot M2 repository. Okay, so just let us go and check this mTOR repository. After MUN install, these files will be there as well. So let us go to mTOR repository, go to C drive, go to users, then here you will find mTOR, go to repository, and as per your group ID, okay, so I will show you your pom.xml of project 1 will have all this information. Okay, so here we have provided group ID as project 1 group, artifact ID of the project is project 1, okay, version number is 001 snapshot. Okay, so using this format the files will be there. So we need to go to this project 1 group ID. Okay, so this is the folder project 1 group. This is my group ID under which we will have project 1, and under this folder you will have these two jar files. Okay, so as you can see, project 1 is our artifact ID, right? So this is the format by which it has stored the jar files, artifact ID, then 0.0.1 snapshot, it is the version number. Okay, as per the pom.xml it has created 0.01 shot. Okay, so these files will also contain the same information. If you check with the JDD compiler, okay, so project 100 snapshot will contains main classes, src main java, all these class files. Okay, and dot slash test will contain the test cases. Okay, so these steps are done now. Our jars are ready. Okay, so let us go to project 2 now, and we will require to add this project 1 as a dependency. Okay, in pom.xml of project 2. Okay, so if you go here, let me close it now, it's not required, project 1. Okay, so in project 2, I have one class page 3 and I want to use all the pages and utilities, okay, methods available in these pages, in the utilities indirectly in page 3. Okay, so to reuse the methods, okay, to reuse means you need to call these methods. Okay, so to call the methods, you need to create the object of the class first, right? So if you want to call some methods from page 1, so you need to create object for page 1 class. Okay, so page 1 p1 equal to new page 1. Okay, so currently it will not give you any suggestion because this project is different, project 1 is different and project 2 is different. Okay, so this project have no idea about this page 1 where it is available. Okay, so once you added the dependency, then they will give you the suggestion to import the package. Okay, so similarly we will call some methods from this utility class also. So let us create the object for that also, utility, let's say utility 1 read excel. Okay, this is the class r1 equal to new utility 1 read excel. Okay, we are just creating the objects. Okay, so let us go and add this project 1 dependency in pom.xml of project 2. Okay, so currently this pom.xml do not have anything. Okay, so you will have to add the dependency. So you know that how to add the dependencies, you need to add it under dependencies tag. So dependencies, okay, so under these dependencies you need to create dependency. Okay, so to add dependency you need to add group ID, artifact ID, and version number. Okay, so how to add it, I already created that. Okay, so to use classes from src main java, you need to add like this. So give the group ID as project 1 group. This is the group ID of project 1. Then artifact ID, version number is 0.1. Snapshot. Okay, and scope you need to keep it as compile. Okay, so just copy this. Okay, paste it here. Okay, and just save it. Okay, so as you can see, we have just added one dependency. And now if you go here, you can check here Maven dependencies folder is got created. Okay, and if you check the contents, you can see Selenium jar files are there. You can find testng jars as well. You can see here testng jar is also there. Okay, so whatever jars we added in project 1, okay, this pom.xml, okay, all these jar files got automatically added in the project 2. Okay, we have not added anything in our pom.xml. We have just added dependency for project 1. Okay, so that's how it you don't have to add the dependencies again. Okay, and if you go to page 3 now, let us see. So now you can see previously it was not giving any suggestion for importing, right? So now it is giving import page 1 from this com.pages. Okay, and utility from this package com.utilities. Right, so because now project 2 has have idea like what is the class page 1 is available, where is utility class is available. Okay, after adding the dependencies. So now using the object reference, you can call the methods. So p1 dot, so page 1 contains two methods, m1 and m2. You can see here m1, that will print something in the console, this statement, and m2 will print this statement in the console. And utility 1 have one function and that will print like this. Okay, so let us call these three functions from page 3, p1 dot m1 and p1 dot m2. Okay, and using utility Excel utility reference, you can call the function, call function 1 dot function. Okay, so if you run this program, okay, using Maven, so that will print this statement in the console. Okay, these two and utility. Okay, so let us reuse this class as well and then we will run our program. Suppose you want to utilize the highlight element functionalities, so utility 2 highlight element h equal to utility 2 underscore highlight element. Okay, so you need to import the package. Okay, now let us call h dot, that will contain the function 1. Okay, so we need to call this resume 1 method that is present in the, where is it, that is present in the page 3 class. Okay, under this src main java. So from test case, okay, from src test java, you need to call these methods. Okay, resume one m1 method. So let us, I have already created the object for it. Okay, so if you want to call the method this resume one, you need to create the object of this page 3 class first, and using that object reference you will be able to call this method. Okay, so I have created p1 object for page 3 and I am calling this resume one method here. Okay, so this method we are going to run this class. Okay, so just save it. So just right click on project 2, you can see here a red arrow cross. Okay, so you will have to just go to Maven and just update your project. Okay, it's still there. Let me check what is the issue here. Okay, some spelling mistake. Okay, now you save it. Okay, once you save it, just right click. We'll just use Maven test command here. Okay, to run your Maven project, you need to use the Maven test. Oh, we forgot to add the Surefire plugin. So let me add the Surefire plugin where it was. The plugins, let me add it in project 2. Here you need to add it. Plugins build tag. Okay, save it. Now just to update your Maven project one more time. Okay, and now let us run using Maven run as MVN test. Okay, so it has run. Okay, you can see here page one. These are the statement from the page one class, and this is the utility statement, and this is highlighting element. Okay, so this is how we have successfully reused the methods and classes and methods from one project to another project. Okay, so we just added this the dependency for project one in the pom.xml of the project two. Okay, and you can start reusing the methods. Okay, so if you want to reuse some test cases, okay, you want to use this page one test. Okay, so you need to add, this is not correct, let me delete it. Okay, you need to use this. Okay, so copy this and go to pom.xml. Okay, and here you need to add it. Okay, so before saving, let us see if we can access the page one test. Okay, so if you go to test one, okay, we will try to directly call the page one. What is it? Page one test p equal to new page one test. So yeah, it is giving the suggestion, but let me, not sure it will call that method or not, p dot m1 test. Okay, save it. I have imported it. Okay, it's not coming. You can see I am trying to import it, but it's not coming. Okay, so that's why you need to add this dependency. Okay, this is also the project one dependency with a group ID, artifact ID, classifier as a test. Okay, like this. So just save this pom.xml. Once you save it, just right click on your project, go to Maven and update the project. Okay, so after updating, you can see error has gone. Okay, so that package will be available here. Import test cases page one test. Okay, so M1, we are going to call the M1 test from this page one test. Okay, so this M1 test will call M1 method from page one. Okay, that means that will print this statement again, page one M1 method. Okay, so let us run once. We are already done with the setting. So just run this one more time. Okay, so as you can see, this statement is already, okay, that is printed again, because we called the page one test, okay, m1 test method from the page one test. Okay, and in page one we are calling the m1 method from the page one class. Okay, so this is how you can reuse all the methods, all the utility classes and methods in another project. And even you don't have to add the dependencies as well. You just added the dependency for that project, and the Selenium dependency, TestNG dependency, or whatever dependency is added in the pom.xml of project 1, you don't have to rewrite in pom.xml of project 2. Okay, so this will save you lots of your time, okay, and the size of your code, okay, it will decrease your size of the code, and this is a best way to reuse the methods and classes. So that's it for this video. See you in the next video. We will cover another important and interesting topic related to the Maven. Okay, so thanks for watching. See you in the next video.